Space. It's amazing, isn't it? The sheer vastness of it, along with trillions upon trillions of objects in the many billion galaxies of the universe. It's almost incomprehensible to the human brain. And there is still so little we know about the outer space. But of the things we do know, there are some extraordinary amazing things. Hi guys, this is Milk, and today we are counting down 10 facts about space. The furthest man-made object is Voyager 1, and it has messages for aliens on board. In 1977, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 were launched. Their primary mission was to visit Jupiter and Saturn. Voyager 2 continued on to Uranus and Neptune, while Voyager 1 made its way into the interstellar space. Voyager 1 is now further away from the Earth than the distance between the Sun and Pluto. Both craft carry a 12-inch gold-plated audio-visual disc on board, which will act like a time capsule of Earth. This disc contains a variety of content that was chosen by a committee chaired by late scientist Carl Sagan. The disc includes photos and drawings, spoken greetings in many languages, music, and Earth sounds. For the convenience of any alien life forms that discover the golden disc, NASA included a cartridge and a needle for playback. However, the extraterrestrials will first have to figure out how to build a record player and speaker. Including that technology aboard Voyager 1 would have added too much weight and bulk. Not all stars are hot. Scientists have discovered the coldest type of star-like bodies, which at times can be colder than a human body. Astronomers had unsuccessfully pursued these dark entities, called void dwarfs, ever since their existence was theorized more than a decade ago. They are nearly impossible to see relying on visible light. But with the infrared vision of NASA's Wise Space Telescope, researchers finally detected the faint glow of six void dwarfs relatively close to our Sun, within a distance of about 40 light years. Void dwarfs are the coldest members of the star-like bodies, known as the brown dwarfs, which are odd objects, sometimes also known as the failed stars. Brown dwarfs are too puny to force atoms to fuse together and release nuclear energy, and so they have only the little heat they are born with. This heat fades over time until all the light they do emit is at infrared wavelengths. So far, WISE has helped us find 100 new brown dwarfs. To see how cool the coldest of these void dwarfs was, the researchers used NASA's Hubble Space Telescope to analyze its pattern of light. They found this coldest void dwarf, known as the WISE 1828+2650, which was colder than 25 degrees Celsius. The silence of space. Space is absolutely silent place. You can't hear even a single sound. This is because, unlike light, sound waves need a medium in which it can travel. But in space, there is no atmosphere, hence propagation of sound wave is not possible. However, NASA has developed instruments capable of capturing radio emissions. When scientists converted these to sound waves, the results were eerie to hear. Here are how our planets in the solar system sound like.
Thank you.
Looking into the outer space, we often assume it would be absolutely silent. Little do we realize, the universe is teeming with planetary music. The sounds these planets give off are absolutely breathtaking and also kind of creepy. A star that shoots water. A star located 750 light years from Earth is shooting waters from its north and south poles. This star is quite young and has some similarities to the Sun. It is shooting enormous jets of water into outer space. The droplets that it emits might be one of the sources of the universe's water and the foundation of life. This stellar embryo hurls water out of both of its north and south poles. Scientists believe that the poles of the star shoots out an estimate of 100 million times the amount of water that flows through the Amazon River in a single second. The water shoots out at an estimated rate of 124 miles per hour. This is 80 times faster than the speed at which a bullet flees out of a machine gun. Located in the North constellation Perseus, the protostar is no more than 100,000 years old and remains swaddled in a large cloud of gas and dust from which the star was born. Using an infrared instrument on European Space Agency's Herschel Space Observatory, researchers were able to peer through the cloud and detect telltale light signatures of hydrogen and oxygen atoms moving on and around the star. After tracing the paths of these atoms, the team concluded that water forms on the star where temperatures are few thousand degrees Celsius. But once the droplets enter the outward spewing jets of gas, 100,000 degrees Celsius temperatures blast the water back into the gaseous form. Once the hot gases hit the much cooler surrounding material, at about 500 times the distance from the Sun to Earth, they decelerate, creating a shock front where the gases cool down rapidly, condense, and reform as water. The really interesting part of this discovery is just how far the waters are propelled, and the possibility that this stage may be the part of life for many more protostars. If this is the case, the prospects of stars like these distributing water throughout the universe is incredible, considering the implications for life that water brings. Magnetars. In a large star such as the Sun, hydrogen atoms fuse and become helium. Helium is heavier, so it sinks to the center of the star. As helium fuses, it creates more energy and carbon is formed. Other than carbon, elements such as iron and neon are also formed. Iron doesn't produce energy, and as more iron is created through the fusion process, the star starts to burn out. Gravity squashes the star in the process, reducing its size, and gradually the temperature rises due to compression. Finally, the star collapses and explodes. This is supernova, the death of a star. Some stars are so big that these supermassive stars explode in hypernova, and the gravity gives rise to stellar remnant called the black hole. However, sometimes these explosions leaves behind a different stellar remnant like a white dwarf or a neutron star. And sometimes these neutron stars spin about their own axis and create a massive magnetic field. This neutron star is called Magnetar. The strength of magnetic field around the Magnetar completely boggles the imagination. The magnetic field of Earth's core is about 25 Gauss, and here on the surface, we experience less than a half a Gauss. A regular bar magnet is about 100 Gauss, while just a regular neutron star has a magnetic field of a trillion Gauss. Magnetars are 1,000 times more powerful than that, with a magnetic field of quadrillion Gauss. They are so powerful that if you get close to a Magnetar, within about 1,000 kilometers of a Magnetar, the magnetic field is so strong that it messes with the electrons in your atoms. You would literally be torn apart at an atomic level. Even the atoms themselves are deformed in a rod-like shapes, no longer usable for your precious life's chemistry. A common myth about space that is often seen in the movies and TV series is that asteroid field is occupied by numerous irregular shaped bodies called asteroids or minor planets, and traveling through it is next to impossible or very dangerous. However, this isn't actually true. Space is gigantic, and asteroid fields are no different, with flying chunks of rock are separated by huge distances. In fact, when NASA sent the probe through the asteroid belts in our own solar system, it had a chance of 1 to 1 billion to get hit by an asteroid. NASA developed a satellite called LAGEOS, Laser Geodynamic Satellite. It is placed in an orbit in such a way that it could be seen from ground stations. The stations are located in the US, China, France, Poland, Italy, Japan, Australia, Mexico, and Peru. The satellite is set to crash land to Earth in 8 million years, carrying a message addressed to the human beings or future civilizations. The message is about the Earth, and the message is divided into three parts. It includes one from 268 million years ago, one from present days, and one an impression of the future. The Hercules Corona Borealis Great Wall is the largest known superstructure in the universe. But according to our current understanding of the universe, it is actually too big to even exist. It is a huge group of galaxies forming a giant sheet-like pattern. It is about 10 million light-years long, 7.2 billion light-years wide, and almost 1 billion light-years thick. The structure is 10 billion light-years away, which means that we see the structure 10 billion years ago, when the universe is only 13.8 billion years old, and its light was just approaching us. The 3 billion year span of time is too short for a giant structure of 10 billion light-years long to even form. Rogue black holes. In the past 2 years, scientists have succeeded in numerically simulating black hole mergers that incorporate Einstein's theory of relativity. One of the biggest surprises to come from this effort is the prediction that when two black holes combine that are rotating at different speeds or are of different sizes, the newly merged black hole receives a big kick due to conservation of momentum, pushing it away in arbitrary direction at velocities as high as 4000 km per second. And scientists believe that there could be hundreds of rogue black holes, each weighing several thousand times the mass of the Sun, roaming around the Milky Way galaxy. And the scary part is, they would be very difficult to spot, unless it's swallowing a lot of gas. About the only way to detect the approach of such a black hole would be to observe the way in which its super strength gravitational field bends the light that passes nearby. This produces an effect called gravitational lensing that would make the background stars appear to shift and brighten momentarily. There could be one coming at us right now, and we might never notice it. We are insignificant. It can be difficult to grasp just how vast the universe and its planets and stars are, especially in relation to Earth. We like to think highly of ourselves, in particular, but also in general. The human race did this, the human race did that. We could someday go, become, and explore. But most people never really realize how insignificant Earth really is in the grand scheme of the universe. There are billions of galaxies having millions of trillions of stars, most of which have their own planets. It truly gives you the sense of scale. This is the Earth compared to the Sun. Terrifying, isn't it? Well, there are stars who are much, much bigger than our wimpy Sun. Arcturus is over 16,000 times larger in volume than our Sun. Alpha Scorpii is about 690 million times larger in volume than our Sun. VY Canis Majoris is about 1.9 billion times larger in volume than our Sun. But nothing is compared to the galaxy. This is our Milky Way galaxy. This is where we live, a small speck of dust inside a huge desert. And this yellow circle is the only stars you're able to see at night. Now let's think a little bigger. This picture was taken by Hubble telescope, and it contains thousands of galaxies, and each galaxy contains billions of stars. Each star is orbited by its own planets, and all of that was seen in just a small patch of sky. Now let's look a little further. This is Earth. This is the solar system in which Earth resides. We are surrounded by several other planets and orbit a star called the Sun. Further out in space, there are several solar systems surrounding ours, forming what we call the solar interstellar neighborhood. Each of these solar systems contains stars and planets. This is the Milky Way galaxy. See that tiny, tiny dot? So tiny you can't even see it? That is our solar interstellar system. From here, we can't even make out our own solar system, let alone the individual planets. The galaxy is enormous. We are rotating what is believed to be a black hole. Current scientific estimates conclude that there are approximately 100 billion stars in our own galaxy alone, with planets orbiting them. As we travel further into space, the entire galaxy becomes just a dot of light. Each of those other dots are other galaxies. Further away, it is possible to see the Virgo supercluster. The red notion represents our local galactic group, containing all of the galaxies near us. In that is our Milky Way galaxy. The local supercluster group contains the Virgo supercluster, where we are located, as well as the other superclusters near us. That tiny dot that you can hardly make out on the screen is the Virgo supercluster. All of those other dots are superclusters, and this is just the observable universe that we can estimate. It is believed that there are countless, perhaps even infinite other dimensions. Theoretically, planet Earth could have an entire civilization that exists in other dimensions we can't access or interact with at the present time. Then there is the issue of time and gravity. If time travel is possible, all of these universes would be occurring at the same time everywhere in all dimensions.